just tell me, what did you do? Did you get to? I don't want to hear where it went. I want to know what the word of the Lord says about me. Listen. The church is dying. Let me do this for like a few minutes. There was a man, David's best friend, Jonathan. The Bible said Jonathan and David was nearly together. And the Bible said that Jonathan had a son. Jonathan had a son that David didn't even know about. See, Jonathan wasn't worried about telling David everything. He was worried about getting a word from the Lord. But this time, and the Bible says that Jonathan's son was left with a handmaid. And somebody was coming and said the handmaid dropped the little boy. I said, when he dropped the little boy, he became crippled. Oh, y'all ain't gonna talk to me. Look at the label and say, crippled. See, he became crippled. His name is Mephibosheth. That was his name. And he went down to a place that took him when he couldn't walk. When he couldn't do nothing. They took him down to a place called Lotaba. Lotaba means a place without a word. The devil want to be slick. He want to take you somewhere where there's no word. He want to keep you crippled. He want to keep you down. Because if you hear a word from the Lord, you will get up off your sickness. Listen, I heard a word from the Lord.
Listen.
And as they departed, Jesus began to say
multitudes concerning John.
Wait a minute, listen. John been raised up in the desert. Listen, Calvin, what am I preaching? Calvin, I love this teaching. Characteristic of a desert child is they know how to survive.
Amen.
I'm a desert baby. I was born in the desert. I know how to survive. I know when it ain't no water. I know how to preserve mine. I know how to eat from heaven when there's no food. I know how to wait on the hand of the Lord. I know some of y'all want it right now. But when you're dealing with God, you can't have everything right now. He got to show you who he is. He got to show you the power that he's possesses. He got to listen, he got to work. Listen, he got to speak in your situation. Somebody say, thank you, Jesus.
What? When he out into the wilderness.
Y'all went out in the wilderness. What did y'all go out there and look at? Jesus knew the thoughts of people. He said, y'all ain't coming for no other reason but no church. Bitch, I'm tired of church folk that's coming to church just to see what other folk do. See what other folk need. I need Jesus myself. I ain't got time to come and watch what you need. I got to get that twink out of my eye before I worry about that speck in your eye. Oh, y'all ain't going to talk to me. Stop looking at me and say, stop being a spectator and start participating in what God is doing. We sung a song this morning, Lord, that whatever you're doing in this,
yes,
whatever you're doing in this season,
yes,
don't you do it without me. Lord, I got to hear what you're doing so I can move with you. I want to hear him speak in my ear. Listen, I'm going to close with this thought. Listen. Oh, you know, I can't keep my word. You know what separates Martha from Mary? Martha was so frustrated all the time. Anybody frustrated? Martha was so frustrated all the time because she was doing so many things in the church. The Bible says she was doing much service. Help me preach today. Doing too many things and nobody, you didn't hear what you're supposed to do. And she got mad with Mary because Mary was doing that thing that was difficult. And the Bible said, Jesus told her, she said, Lord, tell my sister to get up and help me. I've been cleaning the church. I've been praising on the praise team. I'm tired. I've been assisting the bishop. I'm tired. I've been a deacon on the deacon board. I'm tired. Tell somebody else to help me. Oh, you looking at the wrong one. Don't call me to help you. Why? I think that's what Mary said. Mary said, look at him. Jesus said, look at him. There's one good thing. There's one thing that's needed. Look at the neighbor and say, I need this. I need to hear a word from the Lord. I don't need to come out and walk Martha work. I don't need to come out and do nothing but hear the words of the Lord. And Jesus said, there's one good thing I'm not going to take from her. She's doing the right thing right now. She's sitting down with me. Talking to me. Let me just break this down and go home. See, some of y'all never spend time sitting at Jesus' feet praying. Some of y'all don't even know what prayer is. You think prayer is just saying, lay me down to sleep. Pray my soul to keep mine. But I heard the word of God says the effective, fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. You got to get deep down in there. You got to trade places with the person that you are praying for. You got to sympathize with them. You got to pretend that it's you that's in that trouble. If you pretend that it's you in that trouble, God will move. Look at the lady and say, what you come out here to see? Listen, I kept my word. I kept my word. I beat Bishop. I'm going to let y'all go home early. Prepare for the holidays. Listen. But while you're preparing for the holidays, don't forget. Don't forget to hear from God.
Yes.
Leave folks alone. Because see, the kingdom of God is not by observation.
All right.
You can't see this. You got to hear this.
Amen.
That's it.
You can't see this.
Right.
You got to hear this. And if you hear, you can speak it, and it'll come to pass. Look at your neighbor and say, man, I'm through coming out here just looking.
Yeah.
I'm coming out here getting in.
Yeah.
Listen, you want to be like the man at the pool of the best. I don't need nobody to put me in. I'll call me in myself. I know where the pool is, but I'm going to be here every day. I'm going to just crawl my way. I'm going to push my way in there. I'm just going to get in there. Somebody say, get in there. I'm getting in there so they keep coming to church. I can stay home and watch the football game.
Yeah.
But I want to hear a word from the Lord. Come on, set up your feet and put out the brakes. I didn't say give me a praise.
Alright.
I don't need your praise. I ain't died for you.
Amen.
Listen, I say give Jesus a hand.
Amen.
Thank you. Listen, he's done so much for you.
Yes.
You wouldn't be here today if it had not been for your loving God.
Amen.
Amen. Somebody, I bet you heard. Or you see somebody, or you know somebody, didn't make it today. But God had mercy on you and gave you another opportunity to give your hand to praise him. Now come on and give him a praise. I couldn't hear one day. Which one of the two ladies you said that God was going to heal them? Which one? Which yet? Yeah. Which one? Raise my hand. Tell them right back. Okay, you just raise your hand. Listen, you ain't even got to stand.
I'm sure.
Listen, who else was it? I tell you, let's just give it for that. All you can make got a little pain in your body, I want you to lift your hand.
Oh, yeah.
Listen, that's it.
Yes.
See?
Thank you, Lord.
I didn't come to pray.
All right.
I heard the word.
Yes.
The word said, you're sick. You have to call for it. You got to get around somebody who knows more. Stop hanging around all them dolls. Are you listening to me?
Amen.
I need to talk to them. Everybody sit down for me real quick. Except the ones who have their hands up. I want you to keep your hands up. If you can, just if you can, I need you to stand up for me. If you can.